All right. Now, I want to help you guys get better. Whether you're a clear out for trick shotters, whether you just want to be good at the game, whether, I don't know, you just want to improve the slightest and you're a really good player already. And I want to play a little slow here to explain some of these things. There are like 5 or 6 things that I think are key in Call of Duty to improve or get better. And those are map knowledge, gun knowledge, awareness, the knowledge of enemies, and the enemies change, that's why this matters. Sometimes, pick him out. Sometimes people play aggressive, sometimes people play slow. If they play slow, you're going to have to like counter in or add in a few other things that go on with it. Or if they play fast, you'll have to add in a few different things and change how you play and where you look. So that's why that matters, the knowledge of enemies. And it goes along with prediction. That's another one there, prediction. And then route strength, weakness, and how to compensate for that. Now, if you understand all of these things, you'll be a good Call of Duty player or a good FPS player in general. These are things that are, you know, basically countered in. This guy's playing me in the corner waiting for me. No, he wasn't paying attention earlier. I killed someone in the back over there. So if you can count all these things and you can keep track of them in a game, more often than not, you're going to do well. And I'm going to try to bring everything into this game in a live commentary and show you how I do it. And like I said, these are where tryhard pants come on. This is how you play the game. I think adding in other things as well, like having a headset so you can sound hoarse certain things or hear things, that's pretty beneficial. I don't think a scuff controller helps you too much. A lot of pros were pros before they had scuff controllers, and I play with that one, and I'm okay. So, I mean, I can be better maybe with one, I don't know. But either way, I don't think you need everything. You just, you know, you need some things. And usually, the knowledge that you have about the game and how you play it will trump the accessories that you can buy from them. So map knowledge. Looking at the map, I can see where my teammates are. I can see where the enemy team's at as well with the UAV on. But if I didn't have a UAV, it's very easy to notice where they would be at because they're where my teammates are not. Alright? Now, if we wanted to take a bomb site, you got to play aggressive on one of the bombs to grab control of it because this is one of those maps that defense actually gets control of both bomb sites without doing shit. Not a great search map, but they have them. So you got to get used to it. So if I know the map, I can also detect where people are most likely going to come from. Now, if I shot my gun, they're most likely going to know where I'm at. So this comes into prediction. If I shoot my gun and I give away where I'm at, they know where I am all of a sudden. But I don't want to be predicted. I don't want them to find me unless I'm ready for them. So I have to move around like that and kind of throw them off. So when they go to look there, I'm no longer there. They had a guy in here earlier. Keeping track of where people are located helps you find out where they're going to be or where they could have gone. Like that sniper ran there. So gun knowledge. Let's bring that one in. I'm using a long-range rifle, so I'm playing A-side. B-side is also decent for long-range rifles, but more often than not, they have a bigger advantage. So I like to play an advantage that's more beneficial to me. Sniper's down there. How many fucking Bettys do they have? They had an M8 guy on the other side of the map. I'm going to arm it really quick before he gets over here. I'm going to lay down behind the bomb so we can't really shoot through it very well. Bomb's a pretty good protector on this one. And I'm going to jump to the right as soon as I arm it, because at that point I shouldn't get shot. There we go, I heard him. That was where the headset comes into play. Since I'm running awareness, I can sound whore. I don't always need it. I would have checked the door anyway just to make sure he wasn't coming from our spawn. Last I knew, he was in between middle and our spawn. That's where the awareness and prediction comes in. More often than not, a dumb player or a not smart player, I don't want to call him dumb, but like an average player, is going to take the most direct way to the bomb. And that's usually predictable. If you're predictable, you can get killed very easily in search. So you try to do the unpredicted, or try to be unpredictable in any way. As long as you have the time to spare. If you didn't have enough time to walk around through his spawn, I understand why he went that way. So I'm covering the long-range sightline with a long-range weapon here. Same, going back to the gun knowledge. Awareness, I've showed you multiple times what to do. Since there's no one here yet, and they're usually there by the timing that I was covering it, I can push up most likely. That comes with just map knowledge. Burst through the wall if I can hit him there. By map knowledge, I mean I know where they spawn at. I know the point that they can get to, and I know how fast they can get there. On average, I don't know the exact time. It's probably about 8 seconds. So if I can get there before then, and I can aim down sight and wait for a second, usually they're going to be within the time limit, give or take a second and a half to 2 seconds max. If they're not there by that time, more often than not, you're actually pretty safe to move forward. And that lets you kind of play aggressively quicker. Unfortunately, my teammate walked past the one in the spawn over here. Oh, he was in the house. Never mind. So my teammate walked past this guy as he was on the outside there. He walked past him, this guy right here. This guy's just been sitting in the corner the whole time. And again, if you're playing solo, you kind of have to expect your teammates to be absolutely worthless, because 99% of the time, they're going to be absolutely worthless. That's just part of the game. They put the dumbest people they can find with you, and that's so it evens out. If you're a semi-decent player, you know, it's just what happens. Those guys actually killed the person on time, but they weren't smart enough to know how to grab the bomb within the time limit, so they're going to die for it. We lose the round. So let's go to route strengths and weaknesses. This is something a lot of people don't know as well. A lot of people think that you have to take a long-range weapon on long-range routes, which more often than not is true. But if you know the weakness of a route, and I know it's a long-range route, and I take an SMG, I can make up for it. We're going to call that compensation. You can compensate for a long-range route with a short-range weapon, so long as you have something to keep people away. Now, a good example of this is with the Scorpion. I'm going to use a short-range weapon, I'm going to take it on a long-range route, but I'm going to use a stun grenade to keep people off of it. If I keep people off of it, it allows me to be closer to them, so I can then get the kill. I got a hit marker, so there's most likely one back there. I'm going to check the corner with a grenade. And unfortunately, I threw the grenade to the wrong spot. So I died because I took a short-range weapon on a long-range route. I threw the grenade to the wrong location, thinking he was on the corner right there, and instead he was in the far back behind the house. But that's how you can compensate for a long-range route with a short-range weapon. And more often than not, if you can break the long-range spot, like if I can get past that little alleyway and then push up, I'm much better with an SMG at that point than using a rifle. This happens on a lot of maps. This map is a little bit of an exception. More than like 90% of the sight lines you're going to encounter on this map are long-range. So typically a rifle is going to be the better gun. There are short-range spots that work out. Typically, it's inside houses, like here inside wood, or maybe stage 14. But even then, rifles are going to be useful 90% of the time, where SMGs are only useful that 10%. This guy will die in one shot if he gets hit here. He's got to stay down. I wouldn't try peeking the door. It's slow. Never peek a door slow, because they're going to see you before you see them. It's just always a bad scenario. About to expire. This guy's playing defensive and campy, but he has the objective here in the middle, so this is pretty smart. My guess is he gets a hit marker with the shotgun and the M8 guy 2 bursts him, but that's just my guess, because typically when you see the bomb, you don't want to sit directly on top of it. Did whiff the first shot. Got lucky that I didn't check the corner, though. Checking your corners is obviously an important thing with camping in the game. It happens in every Call of Duty game. Some are worse than others, but more often than not, you have to learn the common camping spots so then you don't die from them. It's just, unfortunately, a part of the game. You have to be used to it. And that goes with any FPS game, frankly. Call of Duty, Counter-Strike. Nice. People will camp on certain head glitches or in certain areas because they're the most advantageous to them. You just have to expect that and then kill them when they're there.
Feel free to leave a like if you enjoyed an area.
I want to do more of these in the future, especially with Black Ops 3. That way I can help you improve in a newer game. I didn't do much of it in the beta because it was still the beta and I was learning myself. But I've got a decent understanding of the game and I believe I can help you guys get better at it if you'd like to. Not only am I going to do that, I'm going to do fun videos as well, don't worry. But I still want to help you guys get better if I can. Have a good day, bros, and I will see you later.